Hello students, welcome to the class of Editorial Decode, and in this class I will be decoding the missing conservative intellectualism written by G. Sampath. Now from examination point of view, this will help you in general studies mains examination paper 2. Plus this is very important for economics optional students, public administration optional students and sociology optional students. Now, in order to understand this editorial, we must know about the character of our country. We must know about the nature of our country. We must know about what changes we have actually introduced in our country before we try to understand this editorial. Now, as far as India as a country is concerned, it operates in three realms. The first realm is the political realm. The second realm is the social realm. And the third realm is the economic realm. Now, since independence, we have progressed a lot in two domains. We have progressed politically and we have progressed economically. Now, when India got its independence, we were actually more inclined towards left. But after 1990s, we have actually veered away from the path of leftism and we have put ourselves towards the rightism. So, Indian economy is basically a rightist economy now. Rightist with a slight tinge of left. That generally we tend to call it as the aspect of socialism. Then about politically, India was a subservient country. India was under the suzerainty of the Britishers, and from its suzerainty we have become autonomous, and politically we have been able to entrench democracy. We have been able to provide people with the values of liberalism, with the values of freedom, with the values of autonomy. But as far as the domain of socialism is concerned, we are still stuck in this domain. We are stuck in this domain because of the debilitating effect of the caste and the debilitating effect of the religion. We are not removing this religion from the denominator of everything that we are doing. Now, this editorial is about the intellectuals, about the conservative intellectuals. This editorial is actually a response to an article that was written by Ramchandra Guha about where are the missing conservative intellectuals, that why India is actually devoid of the conservative intellectuals, basically of the right wing. Now, in order to understand this, we need to understand the character and the nature of our country. India is basically a conservative country. Now, why India is a conservative country? We are conservative politically, we are conservative socially, and we are conservative economically. But we are more conservative socially. Now, socially, why we are conservative? We are more conservative because our entire thing, our entire setup is based on religion and on caste. Now, as far as the thought, the intellectuals are concerned, they can be compartmentalized into two types. They are the leftists and the rightists. The leftists, they believe in creating new setup, they believe in infusing new energy, they believe in revolution, they believe in complete transformation. This is what is meant by the left. Now, as far as the India leftist parties are concerned, as far as the India's left intellectuals are concerned, they are actually not that ideal. They are not that pure. If we want to test it with the standards of what is meant by left, then the Indian intellectuals, they are not leftists. Now, why they are not leftists? Because left means complete transformation, complete annihilation of caste, complete erasal of caste, complete erasal of religion. Now the leftists, they are more concerned about the social domain. They are concerned about the social domain, and for the transformation of the social domain, they want things to be done through the way of economic channel. What is meant by it? Leftists kya chahte hain ki agar aapne ek naya social order set up karna hai desh mein, agar aapne equality ko sthapit karna hai desh mein, agar aapne sabko equally treat karna hai, to sari jo property hai wo state ke paas jayegi. There will be no private property. And the leftists, they also believe that there is no God. For them, God is dead. Religion is dead. For them, caste is nothing. They just believe in complete equality. They just believe only in the system of uniform governments. Now, the leftists, they want to endanger, they want to engender, they want to create a social setup, equitable social setup. But as far as the India's leftist intellectuals are concerned, they have never negated this concept of caste. They have never negated this concept of religion. They have just focused on the economic domain. So the Indian leftist intellectuals, they are actually partial ones. They are actually pseudo ones. They are actually diluted leftist intellectuals. Now the liberals in India, they are not completely liberals, because we have no thinker till now. जब से हमारा देश आजाद हुआ है, B.R. अंबेडकर को छोड़के हमारे पास कोई भी अभी तक ऐसा thinker नहीं है जिसने intellectually कोई thought लिखा हो, किसी ने कुछ अच्छा research paper publish किया हो against the annihilation of caste. We are actually devoid of such writers. So we never had a liberal which would have been able to create a kind of a movement. Now you can compare this with the Marxism. Now the Marx, he was able to put forward a thought, and his thought was implemented by Lenin and Stalin. His thought was implemented in China by Mao Zedong. Its thought was implemented in various countries, but in India we have not been able to implement, because our intellectuals are pseudo-intellectuals, they are partial and diluted. Now take the other side, the right-wing intellectuals. Now this editorial is more about the right-wing intellectuals. Right-wing intellectuals are the ones that have their affiliation with the BJP government. Now why are we lacking in this right-wing intellectuals? I have told you about why we are lacking in the left-wing intellectuals. We are lacking in the right-wing intellectuals because the ideologue that they profess, that they propagate, is actually not a rational one. There is no logic in this thought of right-wing intellectuals. ये बताना लोगों को कि आप अगर particular religion के और oriented होगे तो आपकी जो social life हो वो किस तरह improve होगी. So this is very very difficult. Social welfare, you cannot justify religion doing any betterment in your economic life. This is the most difficult aspect to justify. आप कभी नहीं कह सकते आप इस religion में आ जाओ आपका economic upliftment हो जाएगा. We generally talk about social and spiritual upliftment. And this is something that is really intangible. This is something really that we can't touch. So, इसीलिए जो justification है right-wing intellectualism का growth क्यों नहीं हुआ? Because there is no justification, there is no rationality, there is no root, there is no base, there is no foundation. And without base, rationality and foundation, people will not be accepting it. Now, why people have accepted the leftist thought? Why people have accepted the French Revolution, the American Revolution and the Russian Revolution? Because these revolutions were something that the people could really feel. The people could really feel that there is a substance in these thoughts. So this is all for this editorial decode. You can subscribe to this channel. Name of the channel is EIS Mentors. You can contact me at 8459-4000. In case you're interested in buying the video classes on entire civil services preparation. Now, how to view the information of the classes that we are offering, please visit our website eiasmentors.com and brainiki.com. And you can also install our application. Name of the application is Brainiki. You can find the application from Google Play Store and from App Store. And in case you like this video, do share this video, do comment on this video, and do like this video. So this was all for the day. Bye bye. Take care. Have a nice day.